When setting wages, firms face two opposing forces. Lowering wages increases profits, but if wages are too low, workers may leave for higher-paying firms. This means that employers are constrained by their workers' outside options, and most labor market models assume that workers know what that wage distribution looks like. But what if this isn't true? If workers misperceive the wages available elsewhere, firms may be able to pay lower wages than they otherwise would. This paper assesses the accuracy of workers' beliefs about their outside options using data from Germany. A representative sample of the population was surveyed on their beliefs about the labor market, including their expected wage change if forced to switch out of their current job. These responses were then linked to administrative data covering the universe of German employment subject to Social Security. This link allows the authors to assess the accuracy of workers' beliefs. They compare respondents' stated beliefs to their actual outside options, as proxied by the wage changes realized by coworkers who experienced involuntary moves to other firms. To help frame the results, consider this figure. The y-axis measures workers' subjective beliefs about their outside options, while the x-axis measures their actual outside options. If workers have accurate beliefs, this relationship should have a slope of 1. But suppose workers anchor their beliefs on their current wage. In other words, they may believe their outside option is closer to their current wage than it actually is. In this case, the slope of this line would be less than 1. Workers who would experience a positive wage change from switching employers underestimate that outside option, while those who would experience a negative wage change overestimate it. The stronger this effect, the flatter this line becomes. And in fact, the empirical relationship is almost flat. Workers' beliefs about their outside options are strongly anchored to their current wage and are relatively unresponsive to actual outside options. These misperceptions also extend to other aspects of the labor market. In addition to their own expected wage change, respondents were asked about the wage changes experienced by typical coworkers moving out of their firm. These beliefs also exhibit anchoring. In firms where coworkers realized positive wage changes upon leaving, respondents underestimate this change. Workers on average also underestimate the median salary in their occupation, and too many of them rank themselves in the middle of the wage distribution. This figure compares the distribution of respondents' beliefs about their rank with their actual rank. Over 50% of respondents believe they rank between the 40th and 60th percentiles, even though only 19% actually rank in that interval. Similarly, only 5% of workers believe they rank in the top or bottom decile, while the actual number is 17%. So, how might these misperceptions shape labor market dynamics? The authors develop a simplified model to show that when workers have biased beliefs about their outside options, this can sustain wage markdowns and wage dispersion. Intuitively, when it is costly for workers to search for another job, their beliefs about their outside options affect their behavior. They will only pay the cost of searching if they believe sufficiently higher-paying options are available. This means that if workers' beliefs are anchored on their current wage, low-wage firms can retain workers whose beliefs are relatively more biased and push down their wage. This can lead to a segmented labor market where workers sort into high and low-wage sectors. Those who underestimate their outside options are concentrated in the low-wage sector, while those with accurate beliefs move to the high-wage sector. And these dynamics do appear in the data. This figure plots the wage change from involuntary moves against firm-specific pay premia. Firms on the left are low-wage firms, while those on the right are high-wage firms. The administrative data show that workers who leave low-wage firms do experience larger wage changes relative to those leaving high-wage firms. But the gradient of workers' beliefs is relatively flat, and there is evidence of sorting. Workers in high-wage firms have roughly accurate beliefs about their outside options, but workers in low-wage firms strongly underestimate theirs. This suggests that workers' misperceptions may be instrumental in sustaining the viability of some jobs. And indeed, the authors calculate that between 10 and 17% of existing employment relationships would not be viable at current wages if workers had accurate beliefs. Notably, the fraction of non-viable jobs is higher in low-wage firms. Finally, consistent with the model, workers' beliefs do predict their search behavior. Those with more positive beliefs about their outside options have a higher stated probability of searching for a new job. In contrast, intended search behavior is uncorrelated with a proxy for actual outside options. Thus, workers' beliefs about their outside options are anchored on their current wage, and this shapes labor market dynamics. Why does this bias persist? It's possible there are contributing factors from both sides. Firms may have an incentive to obfuscate their wages, but privacy norms among workers may also hamper pay transparency. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. These include papers on wage dispersion, worker beliefs, and pay transparency.